Our next guest may be highly trained classical artists, but they have the energy of rock stars.
This is so incredibly cool. They have rock star status online as well, with tens of thousands of fans and 80 million video views. You talk about going viral. But this weekend, we get to see New York's Project Trio live in Memphis.
Yeah, they're performing with the Iris Orchestra, and here they are with a preview, Project Trio. Say it's wow. Project Trio. There's the information where you can check these guys out this weekend. All I can say is, wow, you showed out this morning. You make us feel like we're part of the music.
All right. Thank you.
Greg, Peter, and Eric, I think y'all need an Alex. He plays the sax.
You don't want me part of this.
You guys, this is not your mama's classical music.
Yeah, you know, it's not, but this is our mama's instruments, you know? These are the instruments that everyone has always known, and they're highly creative things if you're willing to think outside of the box and make these things make wild sounds.
What made you want to think outside the box?
Well, you know what? We actually have a very traditional training. We were raised as classical musicians, but there are so many amazing types of music out there. Mm-hmm. There is rock and hip-hop, and we were influenced by all of these. So what we try to do is take our classical training and classical sensibilities, and then just add all the music that we love, popular music, and try to fuse together kind of classical music and sounds of today.
As I listen to your music, though, I feel that not only older people, but a younger generation of music lovers or people who will become music lovers can appreciate what you do. Is that also kind of a part of it?
Absolutely. You know, a lot of people say classical music is only for older people, but we love infusing all of these multi-genres to attract young people to instruments and to inspire, encourage them to pull out instruments, get together with their friends, and make music for everyone.
Who inspired you, though? I mean, who motivated you as a young musician?
Well, Greg said it the best. Our mothers were the ones that supported us throughout our music careers. I started playing the cello when I was 3 years old, and she put the instrument in my hand and took me to lessons and orchestra rehearsals and has really supported me, and our mothers have supported all of us through our musical careers.
Go mom. Okay, yeah. What's the, because you all do everything from Guns N' Roses to a little beatbox. What's the song that is probably the weirdest to combine with classical for the ordinary person?
That's an interesting question. Well, I would actually say that Guns N' Roses is pretty out there. You know, again, we're always just trying to come up with the next newest thing, you know what I mean? Trying to find new stuff. So we do a great Rossini. We do a wild Peter and the Wolf. We do Nutcracker. We try to do
Stop putting music in a box.
So well.
Thank you very much.
All right, we'll be checking you guys out this weekend. Honored to have you here.
Great to be here. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Mom, right?
Yeah. Seriously.